إن شهد شاهدان مسلمان فصوموا وأفطروا. If there is two Muslims that have adala, that bear witness that they have witnessed the sighting of the moon, and say fast and or break your fast. He say في حديث عبد الرحمن ابن زيد that we pass. في حديث عبد الرحمن ابن زيد, it was only one person. The hadith of عبد الرحمن ابن زيد ابن الخطاب, it was only بارك الله فيكم one person. But أما the أمير مكي الحارث ابن حاطب, he mentioned about two persons. So how do we reconcile this two hadith? Because here he mentioned because in the hadith of يعني الحارث الحاطب, we understand from it that it is not permissible to fast if you didn't have two persons, that two Muslims that have adala, that have udul to be barakallahu fikum, yani making that witness in this. طيب. So therefore, it is permissible to fast when one person see it, and it is the hadith of Abdurrahman ibn Zayd ibn Khattab. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he mentioned, he say tanbih, and this is a point where we should, alhamdulillah, look into and be diligent about it. He say, وَمَنْ رَأَى الْهِلَالِ وَحْدَهُ. Now, if a person himself seen the moon, he by himself seen the crescent, the moon, he say, فَلَا يَصُومُ, he will not fast, حَتَّى يَصُومُ النَّاسِ, he will not fast until the people, all of them fast. Right? وَلَا يُفْطِرُ, and he will not break the fast if he's seen it himself. وَلَا يُفْطِرُ, and he doesn't break the fast. حَتَّى يُفْطِرُ, until the people all together they break their fast. He say because of the hadith, another hadith of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه. The hadith of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, where the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, he say الصوم يوم تصومون. The fasting is the day that تصومون, that you all fast. It's not the day that you fast, but the day that تصومون, all of you fast. And he mentioned والفطر, breaking of the fast, يوم تفطرون, the day that you will be all breaking the fast. And likewise والأضحية, the day of the sacrifice, he say yawma tadhoon, the day that you all be making the sacrifice. So here it is not mufrad, but rather it is jama, it is everyone. So the day of fasting is the day that all of us will fast. The day of breaking the fast is the day that we all break the fast. The day of udhiyah is the day that we all will be doing the sacrifice. Now the issue of, so we know about these three things, about how the month of Ramadan comes to be what? Come to be known. Number one, words that the moon is sought, the crescent is being sighted. Number two is the 30 days being completed. And number three is the khabar of two or one that is a person of uprightness. Yes, ma'am. Right, the hadith of Amir al-Makki. The hadith of Amir al-Makki, rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'ah, he mentioned, قَالَ عَهِدَ إِلَيْنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ عَهِدَ إِلَيْنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. That we have been, meaning we lived with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he make us to, meaning hold a promise. I'll get the handouts, inshallah, next class. I will get the handouts next class, inshallah. I have it copied, but the brother copied Jazawla Khairan, but I got to put it on the binder for next class, inshallah. So, Allah ibarik fik. Now, the other issue is, ala man yajibu. So, we're dealing with the fourth or fifth issue? Huh? Huh? No, here. Ala man yajibu. Unto who the fasting is an obligation now? Unto who? Huh? Four. The first one was the ruling. The second was the virtue. The third one was the when to start the fasting. So number four, and I want inshallah someone to point that out. So number four is unto whom the fasting of the month of Ramadan is wajib. أجمع العلماء على أنه يجب الصوم على المسلم العاقل البالغ الصحيح المقيم. It is a consensus that the Muslim have that fasting is an obligation. Allahu Akbar. He said, أَجْمَعَ الْعُلَمَاء. It is a consensus among the scholars that it is an obligation for fasting كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ every Muslim. عَاقِل, that is sane. بَالِغ, that has reached the age of puberty. صَحِيح, that is healthy, not sick, healthy. مُقِيم, not traveling, meaning resident. وَيَجِبُ أَنْ يَكُونُ المرأة, and it is an obligation for the woman to be what? Tahira, to be yani clean, to be clean from min al haydi wa nifas, to be clean from the menstrual cycle and from the postpartum yani bleeding. أما عدم وجوبه على غير العاقل البالغ. As in regard to the proof mentioning about not being an obligation upon the one that is not sane, غَيْرُ عَاقِل, a person that is not sane, وَغَيْرُ بَالِغ, and a person that is not, that didn't reach yet the age of puberty, what are the ruling or the hadith or the proof that it is not an obligation upon them to fast? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, he said, رُفِعَ الْقَلَمْ عَنْ ثَلَاثٍ, that the pen is lifted upon three types of people. The pen is lifted عَنْ ثَلَاثٍ. طيب, the pen is lifting عَنْ ثَلَاثٍ, عَنْ ثَلَاثٍ. He said, number one was عن مجنون حتى يفيق, upon a person that is mentally disabled until he بارك الله فيكم gain his sanity. وعن النائم حتى يستيقظ, عن النائم, upon a person that is sleeping until he gets up or wake up. وعن الصبي حتى يحتلم, عن الصبي حتى يحتلم, عن الصبي حتى يحتلم. I will always repeat it three times. عن الصبي حتى يحتلم, and also upon a, يعني a baby, until يحتلم. يحتلم mean having a wet dream. A wet dream. So here it shows, barakallahu feekum, that how to know that a person is baligh, one of them is to know that they have had a wet dream. Tayyib, alaykum salam. And you have other barakallahu feekum where you can know a person is yani baligh or not. Mathalan. For instance, how would you know that, let's say, somebody has a son, for instance, or has a daughter. Now, how would you be able to tell that my daughter or my son now has reached the age of yani puberty? Hassan? Right, for the girls when they see the cycle, number two. For the girls, number two. I'm sorry? Okay, what about it? Right, if they have hair on their armpits, what else? Number three? Yes, if the girls start growing breasts, yes. Number four? Hassan? Alaikum salam. Number four? Five? What else? That's the book of the Sarah Hulle or what? Are you Drame? He's Drame? What's his last name? Drame? Alhamdulillah, the Mohammed Dukure is not here. You would have made the Drame look bad, man. All right. Tayyib, how about the boys, Abdul Jalil? Right, the voice being kind of now, you know, like a strong or deep voice. What else? Yes, having armpits on hair on the armpits. What else? Yes, having a wet dream. Okay, another one. Right, it's slightly. The habits will a little bit change because he will have this type of, you know, challenging, you know what I'm saying, rebellious a little bit. Don't want to hear no, you know, don't want to hear it, right? Rebellious type, you know. And that's why it's important to, alhamdulillah, understand that cycle of the kids too. Because it's a cycle there where really, alhamdulillah, this is the time that the son need the father. That's the time that the son need the father. Because as they say, it take a man to raise a man. That's the time that the father can, barakallahu feekum, relate to the son at the time, right? And this is also the time whereas you will know that it's not about striking him no more. Because it's not going to work. It's going to just make the things worse. But Ra is the time to hold him by his hands and talk to him like, you know, you're talking to a brother at the masjid. Take him for a ride, talk about this, talk about that. You know what I'm saying? Kind of feel him. Kind of, you know, see where he at. But not to rough him up like, you know, but let me take my sweat out. And you trying him, the boy, you know what I mean? Alakuli, it's a time that is important to understand and to... And the other one is also to have what? To have pubic hair. To have growing pubic hair and the likes of this. And this is barakallah. These are things that are important to know. Because, alhamdulillah, by way of it, certain takallufat comes. Certain takallufat comes. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said three things. Three people, the pen is lifted upon them, meaning they are not sinful. They are not sinful. A person that is insane until he gain his sanity. So if a person that is mentally sick, he say words, barakallahu fikum, of kufr, are we going to say he's a kafir? No, the man is not sane. Tayyip. Or if a person is na'im, he is sleeping. He is asleep. Tayyip. Hatta yastayqidh, until he wake up from his sleep. Some people, they talk in their sleep. Now, a person, he say in his sleep, I'm a kafir now. Are we going to say, hey man, you are kafir now because you say in your sleep? No. Because the hadith say, rufi'a al-qalam, that the pen is lifted upon a person that is sleeping until he gets up. Wa anisabi, and a baby, or a child.